So hello friends, welcome to this product demonstration of Prime Plus. I'm sure you would have gone through the investor's presentation before this. My aim in this presentation is to take you through major parts of one of the workshops for you to get to understand what kind of workshops are we providing to you, and along with these workshops, what are the resources that are being provided which will support you in delivering these workshops effectively? So with the link that we give you, you will be able to come to this screen, which is the Prime Meriton Online Academy. You will click on the login, you will put your email ID and the password, and based on that, you will log in. Once you log in, you will come to the time management workshop for which you have taken the franchisee off. And then you will click on resume learning. So once you come on resume learning, you have now gained entry to all the modules of the time management workshop. Let us first talk about section one. In every workshop, section one consists of all the resources that you need to conduct the workshop. So as you can see here in section one, you have got that time management flyer, which is here. Now the time management flyer provides you detail about the workshop, about me. It also gives the participants the modules and the benefits of this workshop, and finally the methodology. So this is sent to the participants at least a couple of days before they come to the workshop, so they are completely aware of what they are going to go through during the workshop. Also, the next step you have is you have the manual, participant manual, also uploaded here. You will see this is our participant manual. And this is what you need to take a printout of. Take out a hard copy of this and hand it over to all the participants. What we have also given you to be a part of the participant manual is something that we call as a weekly scheduler. So this weekly action plan for 4 weeks is also provided to you. And this is used by the participants to make their weekly plan of what they need to do after they finish the workshop. Now, once you click on the introduction link, you will get this video here, which is the first video. You can play this video and then also put it in a full screen mode. And this full screen mode then is also projected on the projector. So this is what you're getting, and I'll just quickly move this to 2x and quickly run this.
Do you wonder how some people are able to achieve so much with their time? Do you sometimes despair at how few tasks you complete despite being so busy? Or do people get frustrated with you about tasks you haven't been able to finish? If so, you likely need to look at your time management skills. It might seem strange to put time aside to learn about time management, spell check or personal goals. Prioritize tasks by understanding to them, reduce and control.
So once you finish this video, you come out of this, and then you can go to the next. Creating the to-do list. Again, you click here, you can put this entire play the video again here. Portal is on full screen mode. And this is how you're going to play section by section. So all videos that are required by you are here. I'll also quickly play it in a fast mode so that we can see a bit of it.
It's a fact of life that some tasks are more important than others. Some obviously have high priority, such as completing a presentation for tomorrow's meeting with your best client, while others may be equally important but have a lower priority. For example, mapping your customers' experience of your company and others like that. It then becomes a matter of analyzing each of your jobs to decide on their priority and importance. This is where a to-do list comes in. And it offers to do this, simply write a list of all the tasks that you need to do. Then assign a priority rank.
So also, whatever actions participants need to do after seeing the video is also a part of the video. So the facilitator has to only play the video, and once he plays the video, the entire knowledge of what needs to be transferred to the participants is given in this one. Secondly, whatever action needs to be done after seeing this video is also provided in the video, making the facilitator free to focus on doing these activities after the video is finished, rather than remembering what all he needs to say or what all he needs to do after the video. So once this is finished, again, you get access to a quiz. So what we have provided is a quiz after some of the modules. And the idea here is not to take a test of the participants, but to make them think as a group. So what we do is make them into different groups, show the quiz, ask them to answer it, so that they get to know that what they have seen, they are getting an immediate feedback that they are also understanding. So creating to-do list gives feel of control, true. Next, to-do list helps you decide which of your commitment comes first. So you have done this, you submit it. And also as a group, as a class, you get an immediate feedback how well you have understood the content. Like here, you have got 2 out of 2 as a class. So it's a great time also for people to clap for each other to say, we as a class have got 100% results after this video and after the quiz. Then you can escape this and go back to the next section. The next section is again available to you. The entire video is available with the quiz. So section by section, you can go through each of these videos. So again, I'll play it with fast mode.
Important tasks are ones that lead you to achieving your goals. Urgent tasks or activities demand immediate attention and are often associated with achieving someone else's goals. We often concentrate on urgent tasks at the expense of more important ones, because the consequences of not dealing with them are immediate. Clearly though, foresee and minimizing procrastination. But you can't predict or avoid every crisis. Here your best approach is to leave some time in your schedule to handle unexpected issues and unplanned important. Following session, we will learn how to manage interruptions. Do not contribute to your own desired outcome. Say no, learn a lot.
So again, I played this in the fast mode and also moved it ahead. So you would be probably seeing it slightly jerky. But that's not how it's going to work, because I can see it completely right? Okay, so again, you go through the quiz. Having gone through the quiz, you go to the next section. So all the content is provided by you in the learning management system that we have provided for you. I like to also show you a few case studies that we have created, especially for this workshop, but in other workshops also. So this is a case study in an animation form.
The marketplace is part of the launch is to provide the sales team with the information they need to pitch the product to prospective customers. This involves writing and producing presentations, brochures, and DVDs. In Moen's opinion, he has a million tasks ahead of him. He grabs a notebook and jots down some of the things he can remember that need doing. When a colleague or his man is exhausted and dejected, Moen trudges back to his office, wondering why things have gone so badly.
What do you think went wrong with Mohan's time?
So again, this is an important part of the case study. After the case study is finished, what are the questions that need to be discussed by the participant is given as a part of the case study. So after the case study, the participants in groups will have a discussion as to what the answer would be, and this would all be connected to what they have learned in the past in the workshop. Again, you finish this, go ahead. This is where you find the solution of the case study. So while each group of participants will come out with some suggestions, we also have a suggested solution which will add more value to the discussion and also make them understand a few things if they have missed out some important part of it. So again, you can play this again.
An itemized and prioritized to-do list, which would have focused his attention on higher priority items first. As he fell behind, he chose tasks that he could complete quickly. Mohan needs to remember that effectiveness, not efficiency, is his primary. This will please his boss and fellow team members. Eliminate, get the task or project done effectively.
Similarly, on section 9, we have the next case study. Section 10, we have the suggested solution. And finally, we have the key learning point. So there are 10 videos with actions that need to be done after the video is given to your facilitator, who can then conduct a workshop based on these. Now I've come to the key learning points. This is the last section of this workshop. And this is a summary of what we have all learned together. So I play this.
In this training session, we have looked at how to manage your time so you can be more productive and achieve your goals. We introduced you to the important urgent principle and reducing interruptions. To-do lists help you to itemize tasks and activities so that you can focus on the most important ones. Which of your activities are the important habit? To use a to-do list every day. Prioritize items on that list. Use all of your time, reduce your stress. And
so this is how you navigate the LMS and navigate all the videos. We have also provided you certain additional resources which will help you conduct the workshop very effectively. Participant manual. Now, what is interesting about this manual is that every single word of what I said in the video is a part and parcel of this workshop and given in the manual. So every word that I said there is given in the manual, so the participants don't have to worry whether they are missing out some major point, because whatever I have said, the entire script is given in the manual itself. The reason why we have given the script of the video in the manual is to ensure that if people are not very proficient in English language, they can read the manual along with the video that is going. Also, while this is not the main reason as to why we are conducting this workshop, I dare say people who are going to go through this workshop are also going to increase their understanding of English language. So everything is given here in the manual. Also, what we have ensured is that all tools are a part and parcel of the manual. Every action that needs to be done by the participants, which is also being talked about in the video, is also in the manual. I'm just kind of scrolling this down for you to see what it is all about. So again, this is a tool here, Eisenhower, urgent important tool. This is how you use the tool. Interruptions, how do you manage interruptions? The tool is given again. So the entire scenarios given here, the questions that they have to fill up after going through the case study is given here. Then the suggested solution is also given as a part of the manual. So this is one resource that has been provided to you. Now, this is a very, very important resource. Now, what it provides a facilitator is that every facilitator will get a facilitator guide for each of the workshops. Now, what we have done is we have broken down this into two parts. One is general guidelines. And general guidelines actually lays down the reason as to what the objective of this facilitator guide is. So we have given it here. The facilitator guide is designed to help you steer the process, encourage discussion, and model effective facilitation to your group. Also in the general guidelines, we have given you what is the facilitator's responsibilities? So what he needs to do before the workshop, during the workshop, after the workshop, everything is given here. How does he take the workshop to the next level? And the interactive activities that he needs to conduct during the workshop. After the general instructions, then we come to specific instructions for time management workshop. How do you commence the workshop? How do you ask questions and get people involved? That is given here. Then after you play the video on introduction, what are the activities you need to do is given here. After you play the next video, again the activities that you need to do as a facilitator. After the third video, after the fourth video. So after every video, what you need to do is given very clearly for the facilitator. And he just has to ensure that he uses this guide to make the workshop a great success. Play the video on scenario. What does he have to do with a suggested solution? So everything given here again. Also, this is the last video. What does he do after playing the last video? And very importantly, how does he close the workshop? So what does he do to ensure that the closure is done? Because see, starting of the workshop and doing the workshop is a great thing. But if you don't close the workshop well, major lessons that you learn during the workshops are missed out. Not only this, what the facilitator needs to do the next day is also given in this manner. Also, what we have done is that we have given some appreciation cards, 10 of them, to the facilitator, which he can take out printouts of in small little card size paper and keep handing it over to the participants during the workshop, thereby ensuring that they are excited and their energy levels are kept high. So this again given to you. In addition to that, we also have a feedback form. So what is the feedback that needs to be taken? And finally, you also have got a certificate of participant available to you. Also, I'd like to bring to your notice that I personally will be focusing on helping your facilitators and you to deliver these workshops to the best level. Now, how I'm going to do it is by two things. In the facilitator guide, my mobile number has been given. And it has been said after you close the workshop and finish the workshop next day, if you have any questions to ask me, you can WhatsApp me on my personal mobile number. And I can then get back to you and we can have a discussion where you found some difficulty in delivery of the workshop. If there was a question that was asked that you did not have an answer to. And I personally will be doing a 1 hour webinar with your facilitator 2 times in a month. So what you'll see is that a large number of resources have been provided to you right from the flyer, participant manual, facilitator guide, action planner, the appreciation cards, the feedback that you have to take, and the certificate. So what we have done in the last 1 year, created this complete package for every workshop that is being provided to you so that we can support you to the maximum.